Welcome everybody. Did you know that there is one icon that 95% of the world population immediately recognizes? Of course you do. And you're right. It's the Coca-Cola brand name. Did you also know that less than 1% of the world population think that Germans can make others smile? So let me just focus on what I can do, and that is make you play smile in a beautiful way. See you in the lesson. Enjoy. Hello all you smiling people. Let me, before you learn with a slow replay, help you with a couple of sections here. First, we have this thing, these arpeggios in the left hand. And now you sit down with me and you do 10 times this one. Okay, the first chord is F and you play it. And you might never have heard that you can actually, you know, set over a finger and complete the chord here. But it's not as hard as you think. So please sit down put your fingers here and play this with me a couple of times slowly. And now you close your eyes. Yes, that's right. Close your eyes, sit down, hold tight, close your eyes, and now you play it again. And you will see, after playing this 4 or 5 times, you know the way. And you see, I've seen tutorials, I've looked around a little bit, and some are teaching this like this. Can you imagine a piano tutorial who teaches you to play this like this? It's blasphemy, people. You can as well tell an ice skating princess to put rubber boots over her skates. It's about the same. It's just not done. We tie this. And you will see, once you did this, you do the same with a G minor chord. Come on, sit down, do it. Here. You do it a couple of times until you can play it blindly. Why blindly? Because you have to be blind on the left side when you focus on the right hand stuff. Okay, so please. And that's already, as we say in Germany, half the rent. It's half the rent to play this piece. And now let's have a look at the beginning, which I told you is this, the hardest bit. And it's the second bar. Okay, it's the intro. And now comes this thing. You probably never even heard that there's a note called D flat. Not even to mention that there's a chord belonging to that note. Yes, there is. And it's the same. Come on, let's have a look. It's a D flat. Here, this is the chord, D flat major chord. And you just do the same. And now comes the trick. My usual joke goes, people think you have to be nailed to the root. Like, and they say, can't stretch it, can't do it. Fuck this tutorial. No, you can actually use the pedal down, and then you tie it, and it's easy, like a Sunday morning. See? And so you do this, and then you do also this one finger over setting. So, yeah, this is a bit, you're not accustomed to this thing here, right? But hey, it's a beautiful piece. We are willing to give some sacrifices for beauty. The ladies do that every morning, 2.5 hours they sacrifice for beauty, and we men do that by drinking loads of beer. Okay, now we have this thing. And now that you can play this by itself, you can manage to focus on these chords. Okay, let's go on. Once you do this left hand in the, we're coming now to the theme, and then bum, bum. Because this figure is staying the same throughout the piece. It's repeated. Even when I add something in the left and the right hand, this is the same. So really, you know already, you play this, you already know half the piece. Bum, bum. And of course, you use the pedal here. When you decide to play this piece, you already know how to use the pedal. I trust in that, because I cannot like tell you how to push the pedal. The pedal, this is the level for that you already know how to tie notes. Pedal down, pedal up, that you don't muddle it up or the sound, okay? That's the trick. Then comes, oh, what a wonderful voicing. And here also, often, it's hard to tie the chords. Let's have a look at these. Here, look at this. You have to tie the upper melody. And what I do is I use the fourth finger here. Yes. So I can tie it. It's important that you tie the upper melody. Well, the melody is always upper. Okay. And here you see, 1, 2, 3. That might be hard for some, but do a little bit of training. If not, you tie. Well, in this way I can, 3, 4, 5. 3, 4, 5. I can tie them all. If you can't, I have an understanding, especially for the girls out there. And then in that case, you tie all the chords up with the pedal. You see? Don't muddle it up. Down, up. Up, down, I mean. Up, down. Up, down. You see? It works wonderfully. Up, down. Up, down. Up, down. Up, down. Up, down. Up, down. Up, down, girl. Yeah, then you're up, down, girls. It was a reference to Billy Joel, as you might have guessed. No, okay. Then we come to one thing that is really hard for the for everybody, I can assume. Just a little bit further on. Now we have this. And now comes the terror. Oh, it sounds beautiful. You know, just to educate a little bit, we are in the E flat 7, 7, 9, and the 13 melody 6. And now we have this. So look at this. We have in the E flat, it also comes back 3 times, I believe. So it's worth having a look. We have the third here of E flat, we have the 7, and we have the A. It's again the sharp 11. Again, you don't have to know, you should know everything. You know, people become suspicious of people who know too much, so just accept it. It's the A, and this stretch is quite far. If you cannot do this, it doesn't steal much of the sound if you just play it like this. You see? But if you can you hear a difference? If you can't hear it, you shouldn't care anyway. You just play one note. Okay, we go on. Blah, 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 blah. Articulation. You know, it's not that hard once you can play. It was smart, Christian. But you can do something about the articulation. Don't play like a German robot. As by now you know I am one. So like played like a human, like, you know, with a con emotion. You know, stretch it a little bit. Just copy my articulation, copy my phrasing. That's how it all starts. You copy the masters, regard me as a master for now, the articulation, and then suddenly you will think, you will see, ah, I understand that feeling. I have kind of the same feelings. I can do it from my own heart as well. Hesitate a little bit, go on with the pace, hesitate, now here you hesitate like hell, and then, yeah, bap, swaying feeling, deet, 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 deet. Accelerate, where's the next page? So and so on, yeah? Give it a little bit of articulation. So now we have something that I promised you is sounds like $1 billion in German currency. That would be like probably $750,000. Compared to 1 million, it sounds like 1 million euro makes about $750,000. Still good, still worth doing this. It's, we come here from the... And now you do this. You see, now it's great we practice the left hand. Because now this is an automatism and you can do the arpeggiation of the right hand chord. And that's all we do. We dissolve the melody by just adding an additional strike of the thumb. A strike of the thumb in daily life doesn't mean much. You know, if you strike, if your son was, you know, was bad, you strike him with a thumb, it doesn't have too much effect. But here, if you strike always the thumb in between, It's marvelous and it doesn't cost us anything. Everybody can that and that and that, and it sounds so much better, creates flow after the first more hesitating themes. Then you create suddenly flow. Isn't that beautiful? Now let's have a look. It's really just the melody if you learned before, and now it's just eh, mm, ba, 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 mm. You can say bappen if you like. It's called bapping. It's not. It's a close relative to rapping. It's called bapping. Okay. Bap, 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 bap. I'm annoying, huh? And then we go on with the next chord. You see the chord signs G minor, so we take the G minor. And we're meeting at the spot in which is the same in all choruses. Yeah? Here. Yeah, it's the same. You practice this also just once, and you have it in all choruses. Let's have a look. Oh, we come here, and we have, it's always the same. Before I played it here, and now it's here. Ding, ding, ding. And off we go, flowing. And so on. It's really just that. It's just adding that additional note, and then we become more reflective. We go become more in like a little introverted music box. Can a music box be introverted? We don't care. We play like one here. Now in the movie there would be a soft filter over it and a kind of remembering, musing feeling of how beautiful youth was. You stay, put your attention here. What I do is here, you take either third finger that you can reach out here and not rearrange your hand. You stay here and you can stay put. Yeah. And then. And it stays like that. Same pattern on the A flat zero. Of course not zero, eh? It's the diminished A flat. And surprise, surprise! What was it? A flat zero. Ah, that makes me thirsty for my Coke Zero. Okay, gotta wait. And hey, don't we know this? Yes, we know. And then we are in the finishing line. We are back to what we played in the beginning, just one octave higher here. You know, we come from the intimate doodle doodin doodin, and then the finishing feeling is coming, and we are all sighing inside and sobbing, and it's, you gotta play it like a sobbing feeling. The beauty has gone, but it's still a world full of love. What a great life. Make peace with what life actually is, a big drama, but full of life. Whew. And the last stretch, that should annoy you here. I could have easily played it like this. but I didn't want to. I wanted to annoy you in the end. Just remember you that life will always be a struggle. Okay. Now comes the slow replay. I hope I could enlighten you with my help. See you later. I hope you liked my tutorial on this beautiful song. If you did, please leave me a thumbs up. It helps me and my channel a lot. And then, well, smile. All the best from Berlin. Take care. Stay safe. Bye.